A federal judge ruling the White House's communication with big tech firms likely resulted in censorship and blocks any further meetings, for now at least. In his ruling, Judge Doughty determining, quote, the Hunter Biden laptop story was censored on social media, including Facebook and Twitter, calling it possibly the biggest attack on free speech in U.S. history. OutKick founder Clay Travis joins me now. Clay, what I find so stunning, there's a lot stunning in here, but let me read you a line. This is from a Meta executive. This Meta executive sends a message to the Surgeon General and CCs, the COVID advisor in the White House, and they say this: we think there is considerably more we can do in partnership. They're in partnership with the federal government, with you and your team, to drive behavior. Is that the role of the federal government and social media?
No, it isn't, Kaylee. And happy 4th belatedly to everybody out there. This was an incredible opinion released on July 4th by Judge Doughty, I think, for a reason. And Kaylee, really, when you boil it down, for people out there who are intrigued by what this judge made a preliminary finding on, he essentially said, look, we know that the United States government cannot restrict what its citizens are saying on social media. And most people out there, Democrat, Republican, Independent, agree with that. But what happened with the social media teams, particularly in the 2020 election, but even more so once Joe Biden took office, which much of this information is focused on, is the United States government began telling these big tech companies, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, making threats essentially against them. And if they did not do what the United States government wanted them to do, there would be consequences. So as a general rule, the government can't do through a third party what it would be prevented from doing itself. Kaylee, as I read this opinion yesterday, I couldn't stop saying thank you. Finally, right. This is going to be incredibly difficult for the Biden administration to overturn. And I hope the media, the New York Times, the Washington Post, ABC, NBC, CBS, MSNBC, CNN, will actually cover this and recognize this for what it was as you brought this in. As the judge says, I truly do believe this is the greatest infringement on our First Amendment rights that any of us have seen occur in any of our lives. It cannot be allowed, and we're finally getting judges pushing back. I think this could be, Kaylee, the most consequential opinion of the 21st century by a district court judge, right up there. And I'm sure you remember this because this was a Floridian judge who did it, with that judge who finally bravely said, hey, you can't have a mask mandate on airplanes. You remember when that happened and they started to announce it on all the airplanes and everybody took them off. That opinion still hasn't been reversed either. I think this one is even more consequential, though.
And let me just underscore for our viewers as we head out, you know, you're not overstating this. They sent a message in January of 2021 asking to censor RFK Jr., and it goes further than that. They also wanted to censor tweets from the Children's Health Defense, a nonprofit run by none other than RFK Jr.
Please join the conversation. Put your comments and suggestions below in the comment section. Thank you for subscribing to this news channel. You will be notified of any breaking news and new post as you become part and parcel of the MCAD TV family. Please like and share MCAD TV. We love you all. Please support MCAD TV Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage projects across Africa.